Dear students, already we have considered rolling motion in the previous video. Just last one topic is remaining. Anyhow, let us consider this from the beginning. See here, a disc is rolling on floor. Any particle on disc will have two types of motions. Two types of velocities. One is translational velocity. See, because it is moving from one place to another place, it has a translational motion, therefore it has translational velocity. And now the disc is rolling rotating about its own axis, therefore it has rotational motion also, therefore another velocity is rotational velocity. So any particle will have these two velocities except center of mass. See, center of mass will have pure translation, only translation, therefore it has only translational velocity. Translational velocity is represented by VCM and rotational velocity is represented by VR. Now if we consider position P naught, let us consider at position P naught. Here, this point is momentarily at rest with respect to floor. When the particle comes in touch with floor, it is momentarily at rest. See, first let us consider translational velocity. What is its translational velocity? That we don't know, because it appears momentarily at rest. But rotational velocity here, VR. See, how we find rotational velocity? Suppose this is a circle, this is axis and center point. Suppose here the particle is here, it is rotating clockwise, it is undergoing circular motion, and it is the radius, and here at any point on circle the linear velocity is in the direction of tangent. So this is VR. So in scalar form, the linear velocity is equal to r omega. Here it is written as VR. So r omega, VR is equal to r omega. See, using this formula here, at this point VR is in this direction. VR is in this direction because it is rotating clockwise, and radius is capital R. Therefore VR is R omega. VR is R omega. Now, and this is to left hand side, so this is to left hand side, therefore minus, this is negative, this is negative. Now since particle at PO is at rest with respect to floor, VCM plus VR, sum of the two velocities must be zero. So VCM plus VR is minus R omega, that is equal to zero. VCM is equal to R omega. So this is the condition for rolling without slipping. Rolling without slipping. Now Let us consider position C. At position C, let us consider the two velocities. V is equal to VCM plus VR. But this is center of mass. Center of mass has no rotational velocity, it has only translational velocity. Therefore, here V is equal to VCM is equal to R omega. Now let us consider P1 position. At position P1, again we can write the equation. Velocity at position P1 is denoted by V1, and it is a sum of VCM and rotational velocity, translational velocity plus rotational velocity. See here, VCM is equal to R omega, VR is equal to here. Let me show VR. Here VR, see, it is rotating clockwise. Here VR is in this direction, and here VR will be in this direction. VR is equal to R omega, capital R here, into omega. Both are same. Therefore, we can write VR is equal to VCM. So here let us substitute in place of VR VCM. So V1 is equal to VCM plus VCM is equal to 2 VCM. So here the velocity is 0, here the velocity is VCM, and here the velocity is 2 VCM. See here V0 is equal to 0. Here the velocity is VC is equal to VC. Here V1 is equal to 2 VC. Here the velocity is 0, here the velocity is VC, and here the velocity is 2 VCM. VCM here 0. Now let us consider another position, say here, and that is P2. So let us consider at position P2. Position P2, velocity is V2. V2 is equal to, it is a sum of translational and rotational velocity, VCM plus VR. VCM is R omega, and VR. So to find VR, let us construct a circle around the axis of rotation. So here is the axis of rotation. Now let us draw a line from this point to center of the circle. So this distance is R2. Here to here, this distance is R2, and it is moving clockwise, omega is clockwise. Therefore, here we draw a tangent like this, and this is VR. This is VR. So VR is equal to R omega, R2 omega. VR is equal to R2 omega. Now substituting the values here, we get V2 is equal to R omega plus R2 omega. So here we take vectorial addition of these two. Vr is in this direction and Vcm is in this direction. In this direction, horizontal. This is Vcm. This is Vr2. This is Vcm. To find resultant of the two velocities, we construct a parallelogram. We construct a parallelogram. Its diagonal gives resultant of the two velocities, and this is V2. This is V2. Now let us calculate kinetic energy possessed by a rolling body. Here a rolling body is rolling on the inclined plane. It has two types of motions. It is moving from one place to another place, that is translation, and it is rotating about its axis of rotation, that is rotational motion. So we have two types of velocities and therefore two types of kinetic energies. So here kinetic energy of rolling body is kinetic energy of translation plus kinetic energy of rotation about center of mass. Here for translation, the kinetic energy formula is half m Vcm square. Why we write here Vcm means all the other particles have both rotational and translational motion, whereas Cm has only translational motion. Therefore, its velocity is taken. Kinetic energy of translation is of m Vcm square. And kinetic energy of rotation, we derived expression for this, and that was half I omega square. Here K, total kinetic energy. This is the total kinetic energy. But while defining radius of gyration, but from definition of radius of gyration, there we defined this physical quantity, and this was related to moment of inertia by an equation I is equal to mk square. I is equal to mk square, where k is radius of gyration and capital M is total mass of the rolling body. I is moment of inertia. And further, just now we have shown that Vcm is equal to R omega, because the disk here is having radius capital R and its angular velocity is omega. Therefore, Vcm is equal to R omega. R omega is equal to Vcm by R. Now let us substitute these values in equation 1. Substitute second equation, third equation in first equation. It gives total kinetic energy is equal to half m Vcm square plus 1 by 2 capital I means mk square. Here omega means Vcm by R whole square. Half m Vcm square plus half m Vcm square is see what is remaining here. K square is remaining in the denominator, R square is remaining. Now taking half m vcm square common, k square by R square. So this is the expression for total kinetic energy of a rolling body. Now let us do the solid example here. Over the inclined plane, three different rolling bodies are used to roll down. One is ring, another is solid cylinder, and third one is solid sphere. Which of the three bodies reaches ground with maximum velocity? That is asked here. So here, when the rolling body is at sea, it has only potential energy, and when we leave the body there, it rolls down and gains kinetic energy. Potential energy decreases and kinetic energy increases, and when it reaches the ground, since here height is zero, it loses all its potential energy, and all the potential energy is converted into kinetic energy. So we can write an equation according to law of conservation of energy. Potential energy at C is equal to kinetic energy at A by law of conservation of energy. Potential energy at C is equal to kinetic energy at A. So just now we derived expression for kinetic energy of a rolling body, and that is half m vcm square 1 plus k square by r square. And potential energy at C is, it is at a height of h, therefore m g h. As the body is rolling down, its velocity gradually increases, and say its velocity at A is final velocity. So let v be the final velocity. Let v be the final velocity. Then in place of vcm we write v. So half m v square 1 plus k square by r square is equal to c. This is m, capital M. Here also capital M. M, G, H. M and M gets cancelled. V square is equal to 2 into G, H. 2 into G, H by 1 plus k square by r square. And 2gh by 1 plus k square by r square. So r v is equal to under root 2gh by 1 plus k square by r square. So this is the, now expression for final velocity is ready. So for the three different rolling bodies, let us calculate the final velocity so that we can find which has maximum velocity. So here, first let us select a ring for thin ring. Now we have to decide out of the three bodies which has maximum velocity. Here expression for velocity is ready. Now if we look at the terms in the formula, see g value is common, h value is common to all the three bodies, and r radius also same for all the three bodies. So the only physical quantity is k, that is radius of gyration. The radius of gyration depends upon moment of inertia, and the moment of inertia is different for the three bodies. So using the moment of inertia values, we have to decide k values. For now, let us consider the thin ring. See, for thin ring, moment of inertia formula is y is equal to mr square, but I is equal to mk square. So comparing these two, we have mk square is equal to mr square, mm gets cancelled, k is equal to r. So in this formula, see, v for thin ring will be 2gh by 1 plus k square. See, k is equal to r, therefore r square by r square under root, so that we get here 1 plus 1 2. So 2 means here 2gh by 2 under root 2 gets cancelled, so gh under root. So in this way we calculate final velocity. Now let us choose solid cylinder. For solid cylinder, I value is mr square by 2 and I is equal to mk square. So mk square is equal to mr square by 2, mm gets cancelled, k is equal to r by root 2. So substituting this value in the equation, v of solid cylinder is equal to 2gh by 1 plus k square is equal to r square by 2. R square by 2, here r square is there, here r square is there. So r square gets cancelled. 1 plus 1 by 2, that becomes 3 by 2. So 2gh into, say, 3 by 2 becomes 2 by 3 under root. So here we get 4 by 3gh under root. Now let us consider solid sphere. For solid sphere, I is equal to 2 by 5 mr square. I is equal to mk square. Comparing, mk square is equal to 2 by 5 mr square, m gets cancelled. K is equal to, k square is equal to 2 by 5 r square. Here substituting in place of k square, v of solid sphere is equal to 2gh by 1 plus k square means here 2 by 5 r square by r square under root. So we get here r square gets cancelled. 1 plus 2 by 5, 7 by 5. 2gh into 5 by 7. So 10 by 7 gh under root. So now we have to compare these values. Here let us note the values here. V of ring, we got GH under root. V of solid cylinder, we got 4/3 GH. V of solid sphere, 10/7 GH. So here 1 × GH, and here 4/3. Now let us compare the values. Here for ring it is 1 × GH under root. For solid cylinder 1.15 under root GH. This is 1.19 under GH under root. See here GH under root is common. Here 1, 1.15, 1.1. See gradually the velocities are increasing. So the highest velocity has solid sphere. So the velocity of a solid sphere is greater than that of solid cylinder, and this is greater than, say I am writing in the descending order, ring. So which of the bodies reaches the ground with maximum velocities? So the answer is solid sphere reaches ground with maximum velocity. See, as far as theory part is concerned, we have completed in this lesson. So lastly, let us have a comparison of translational and rotational motion. See the various formulas or equations we have used so far. See here, displacement, linear displacement is, if it is along x-axis, we show it by x. So this is the linear displacement. And in the rotational motion, we have angular displacement. We have angular displacement, and that is shown by theta. Now second one, velocity, linear velocity, linear displacement by time here. So in place of velocity, here we have angular velocity. Angular velocity, it is shown by omega, and it is here, this is rate of change of displacement or displacement by time. Here we take angular displacement by time, that is d theta by dt. Third one, here acceleration, here angular acceleration. Angular acceleration. So this angular acceleration is represented by alpha, and it is rate of change of angular velocity. Here mass is a measure of inertia in linear motion, and in rotational motion moment of inertia. Will be the measure of inertia in rotational motion. Here force is given by Newton's second law. F is equal to ma. Force causes linear motion, torque causes angular motion. Therefore in place of force we have torque, and in place of mass we get moment of inertia, and in place of linear acceleration we have angular acceleration. Now second one, Newton's second law can also be expressed like this. So force means torque, linear momentum means angular momentum. Sixth one, work done. Work done here is force in place of force we get torque, linear displacement shown by angular displacement. Seventh one, kinetic energy of translation. This here kinetic energy of rotation, half I omega square. Here eighth one, for kinetic energy, translational kinetic energy, k is equal to half mv square. If we multiply numerator and denominator by m, we get in the numerator mv whole square by 2m. But here mass into velocity is momentum. Therefore, k is equal to p square by 2m. K is equal to p square by 2m. So in this way, for kinetic energy, we have two formulas. One is half mv square, another is p square by 2m. That is written here. Similarly, let us write for rotational motion also. One is half I omega square, and another is k is equal to, in place of linear momentum, we write angular momentum by 2i. This is another equation. Now, the eighth one, power is equal to work by time. So here, so for power, P is equal to work is dW, that is FDS, divided by time is delta dt, that is equal to F. DS by dt is linear velocity, FV. So P is equal to FV in linear motion. So similarly, in rotational motion, P is equal to, in place of force, we get torque, and here in place of linear velocity, we get angular velocity. Sorry, P and tau omega. P is equal to linear force, torque. Here linear velocity, here angular velocity. Next, ninth one. Here linear momentum. Linear momentum is shown by P is equal to mv, p is equal to mass into velocity, mass into velocity. So here in if it is linear momentum, here we get angular momentum. Angular momentum is L is equal to, in place of mass we get moment of inertia, linear velocity, angular velocity. We are writing just scalar relation. P is equal to mv, L is equal to I omega. Work energy theorem. Work energy theorem. According to work energy theorem, work done is equal to change in kinetic energy. Work is force into displacement. Change in kinetic energy. So here we can write this as F means torque, linear displacement, angular displacement is equal to half mass means I, initial velocity, final velocity. These are the linear velocities. Here we write angular velocities. Initial velocity is omega naught, final velocity is omega. So in this way, we write. Now, let us compare kinematic equations in linear motion and rotational motion. V is equal to u plus a t, initial velocity, final velocity, linear acceleration, time taken. So here, in place of linear velocity, in place of initial velocity, we have initial angular velocity, here final angular velocity, here acceleration, here angular acceleration t, and here displacement, linear displacement, here we get angular displacement. This is initial angular velocity plus half angular acceleration t square. This delta theta is nothing but theta minus theta naught. And here omega naught square minus omega square is equal to 2 alpha theta. Now let us consider a solved example 7.14. A cord of negligible mass is wound round the rim of a flywheel of mass 20 kg flywheel mass that is treated as a rigid body that undergoes rotation. Its radius is 20 cm, that is 0.2 meter. A steady pull of 25 newtons is applied on the cord. 25 newtons force is applied. 25 newtons force is applied as shown in figure. The flywheel is mounted on a horizontal axle with frictionless bearings. First, compute the angular acceleration of the wheel. First one, angular acceleration means alpha is asked. Second one, find the work done by the pull when 2 meters of the cord is unwound. See, work done is equal to force into displacement, that is asked. And third one is find also the kinetic energy of the wheel at this point. Assume that the wheel starts from rest. So it means initial kinetic energy is zero. So we have to find out final kinetic energy. Final kinetic energy, that is Kf, that is asked here. And compare answers to parts B and C. Okay. Now, with data available, we can find work done in unwinding the rope. See, applying a force of 25 newtons, 2 meters of rope is pulled out. Therefore, force into displacement gives work done. So, B, let us do the B first one. Force into displacement, 25 newtons into displacement is the unwounded length is 2 meters. So, 50 newton meter. Now, afterwards, now let us do the C1. See here, initially the flywheel was at rest. By pulling the rope by 2 meters, it gained some angular velocity. So thereby it gained some kinetic energy. So let us find kinetic energy gained. And the formula is half I omega square. So here, to find kinetic energy gained, we want I value of the flywheel as well as omega value. For flywheel, I is given by mr square by 2. So mass is 20 kg. and radius is 0.2 square by 2, so we get the value 0.4 kg meter square. Now we want final angular velocity. Initial angular velocity, initially it is at rest. Initially, flywheel is at rest. It means omega naught is equal to 0. So omega naught we know, we have to find omega. The angular velocity gained after some time. So we make use of kinematic equation. So in linear motion we have v is equal to u plus eat. Just like that in rotational motion we have omega is equal to omega naught plus alpha t. So here omega naught is 0. But here alpha we don't know. So here omega is required. Omega naught we know, but alpha and t that we don't know. So this equation cannot be used. So let us view the kinematic equations available. See, one is omega is equal to omega naught. It is easy to write the linear version. One is v is equal to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus half at square. Third one, v square minus u square is equal to 2as. See, in our problem, time is not given. So this expression also we don't want. In both are having time, therefore we don't want these two equations. This equation is useful. So its rotational analog is omega square minus omega naught square is equal to 2 alpha here theta. Now omega naught value 0 because flywheel was initially at rest and angular acceleration we don't know. Theta we can find. See here, this much unwounded. So from sector, angle in radians is equal to arc by radius. So initially this rope was here, a part of it was an arc when it was pulled. So this is arc, yes, this and this both are same length. So angle in so this part which was unwounded was a part of arc and it is subtending an angle theta here. So angle in radians is equal to arc by radius. So theta is equal to s by r. So here we want theta only. Therefore, we can write here 2 alpha to s by r. So omega not available. Now, to find kinetic energy gained, we want I value that is calculated. Next, we want omega that is final angular speed. To find final angular speed, we are observing the three kinematic equations. Here, these two are containing time. in the problem time is not given. Therefore, we go for the third kinematic equation. Its rotational analog is this we have written here. So in this omega naught, we know flywheel was initially at rest, omega naught is equal to 0. And here alpha, that we, it is not given in the problem. Now theta. Theta can be found from this figure. See here, initially this rope was here only. Now it was pulled out. So here, when it is a part of this, angle in radians is equal to arc by radius. Theta is equal to S by R. So using this formula, we can find, because the pulled unwounded part length is given and radius of the flywheel is given. Substituting here, we can find theta value, and we can substitute that theta value here. So in place of theta, you can write S by R. So I wrote here, in place of theta, S by R. Now we want alpha. So alpha comes in a equation, tau is equal to I alpha. Tau is equal to I alpha. So here, torque is not, see, tau is equal to I alpha. I we know, but torque we don't know. But torque can be found from a formula. Torque is equal to R cross F. R cross F. First we find torque using this formula. Torque is equal to RF. From tau is equal to I alpha, we find alpha value.